didn't get to know him very much personally because he died when I was about five. But he was a great guy. He was my dad's dad. His real name was Cliff Arquette. He came from a family of vaudeville performers as well. So we're fourth generation, all of the kids. And he was a Civil War buff. He had a museum in Gettysburg that he was really fond of. And he was interested in puppets as well, as I am. And he was just a really cheerful, great guy. Yeah, my father left me after he passed away, a marionette of him, of my grandfather, and a ventriloquist doll. So I'm opening a club in Los Angeles called Bootsy Bellows, and it's going to have performance, music, DJ, and puppets. Well, you know, when people are doing budget cuts, they often look at the arts as one of the first things to go. And obviously, there needs to be cuts, and the budget in general is out of control, and they have to make changes. But we just tried to explain to them that the arts are so important to us that other changes should be made before you even look in the direction of the arts. The arts is our second largest export in America, with music, radio, film, art in general, design, you know, design manufacturing. It really goes through our whole culture, and you know, we're doing a lot of advocacy this time on the National Endowments for the Arts, and just making sure Obama has $154 million, I believe, set aside in the current budget that he's proposing for the National Endowment of the Arts. That's only an $8 million increase from last year. So we're just trying to maintain its stability and not sort of, you know, take it away, because every dollar that is used by the NEA. Sorry. I'm so tired. It returns $7 in tax money just through the halo effect of these different, you know, projects going out and the different jobs that it creates. And, you know, when we do a film somewhere, it creates jobs for the, you know, laundry industry, the transportation, hotels, restaurants, lumber, you know, labor. It's really it's a very profitable, it's a business, and we want people to look at it that way. And not only look at it as arts and music, but also design. I mean, the design that goes in to many of the products that we manufacture, and many of the ideas that we come up with in America that become these companies and these apps and these, you know, films and video games, are all artistic based. And so we're just trying to sort of explain to people the depth of what the arts represent.